got CDs, tapes, and videos, radio and TV shows, conferences, retreats, and seminars. We got books and magazines to read on everything from A to Z, and a web to surf from anywhere we are. But I hope with all this information buzzing through our brains, that we will not let our hearts forget the most important thing. It's love, 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 love.
Hello and welcome to Worth More Than Ruby's Wisdom for Everyday Life. I'm the Faith Walker, Cheryl Lacey Donovan, and I'm joined here today with my co-host, Elder Esther Renee Daniels.
That would be me.
Absolutely. And we have declared this year to be a year of faith. So all of the shows, all of the episodes, the broadcasts that we'll be doing this year are going to be dealing with faith. And our mantra of faith for this year is forsaking all, I trust Him. Amen. And it's so wonderful.
Yeah.
And this particular broadcast is being brought to you by Worth More Than Ruby's Ministries, Titus Works, and TMH Photography. Visit thefaithwalker.org to find out more information about all three of these wonderful organizations and what they're doing here in the city of Houston and abroad.
Amen.
Esther,
yes.
How you doing, girl?
I am so excited. I'm blessed. I'm so excited that God would allow us the opportunity to do what we're doing today. Mm-hmm. I'm excited that people like it.
Absolutely.
That's a blessing in itself. So I believe that the topic that we're going to be talking about is so awesome because there's so much going on in the world today that we really need mm-hmm. to get our faith working.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And you know what? My thing is that, you know, I believe that a lot of us, particularly in the body of Christ, mm-hmm. we give a lot of lip service to faith.
Yes.
But do we really, really have faith when a whirlwind comes about? We're mm-hmm. tossing to and fro mm-hmm. and don't let a big storm come through.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden it's a bunch of mumbling, it's a bunch of complaining. Mm-hmm. And we don't know what to do or where to go.
Well, I think that some people are a little confused. And the reason mm-hmm. why I say that, well, 2 days. My friend told me the other day, she said, we talk a lot about wanting to walk like Christ and
yeah.
be more like Christ.
Yeah.
But then when the mess hits the fan,
yeah.
we're not walking no more. We're
yeah.
like, why, God, why?
Mm-hmm.
But I think that somewhere along the way, maybe we've given a message that says, count it all joy.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't know really what that means, or you know, we're not supposed to complain. God's word says, no, don't complain. But it's more to it than that. And that's
mm-hmm.
why it's so important that people read the word and learn what it really means. If there's verses above verses and underneath, so you need to read it all.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that that's part of the problem, because when the mess hits the fan, we need to realize that, yeah, we're supposed to not count it all joy. We're
mm-hmm.
supposed to count it in joy. Not everything is not going to be joyful,
mm-hmm.
but God yeah. is.
Exactly. And you know what? I think the other thing that we have to recognize too is this, that when we are talking about faith and we want what we want God to do for us,
mm-hmm.
a lot of times it's based on what we want. It's not necessarily based on what His actual plan is.
Mm-hmm.
It's not based on our being in alignment with what that plan is,
yes.
but it's about what we want. And when it doesn't occur the way we think that it should occur,
mm-hmm.
then all of a sudden it's a totally different story.
Yes.
But when you truly have faith
mm-hmm.
and you're spiritually mature enough to recognize that all things, even the bad things,
yes. Yes.
works together for our good,
mm-hmm.
that's when true faith is actually instituted. And I think, you know, sometimes we really don't understand what faith really means, you know?
Yeah, I agree. You know, one of the other things that I tell people all the time, you really don't want nothing that's not ordained by God anyway.
No.
And so I really do wish, when I pray and I ask God to bless me in a certain area, I really want it the way He wants it. Because
mm-hmm.
if it comes out the way God wants it,
mm-hmm.
it's going to be a success, no matter what it looks like.
Yeah.
If it come out the way I want it, well...
sometimes it is, and sometimes it ain't, my baby, right?
Yes.
So today, what mm-hmm. we're going to do is we're going to talk from Hebrews 11.
Yes.
And this is sort of the starting point for all of the things that we're talking about with faith.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to move through some of the other faith siblings and some of the other faith stories. But I believe that if we start here, it kind of gives us a basis or a foundation
mm-hmm.
for the things that we'll be talking about for the rest of the year. And this is what I like. It says, now faith.
Mm-hmm.
And I just need to stop right there.
I know.
Because you know what? When some people read that, they say, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. I like to say, now faith. Not yesterday's faith.
Right now.
Not tomorrow's faith.
Right now.
Now faith.
Yes.
Is the substance of things hoped for. In other words, whatever you're dealing with, whatever you're going through, whatever the situation is, whatever the circle, now faith. You need some faith right now in the midst of that storm to help you take you through.
And you know what else? Do we lose our faith when it's not a storm?
You know, I don't know.
Because a lot of times, even though it say now faith, and whenever we read this verse, it's always about a storm or something going wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But I stopped by it to say that maybe now faith needs to be even in the best of times.
Absolutely.
Because if I lose my focus, because sometimes, you know, we get a little...
Absolutely.
If I lose my focus and I start thinking about what I need, now faith needs to be in here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because I can't do this either way, good or bad, without it.
Exactly. You know, they call that, I've heard somebody else say, WIIFM, what's in it for me? What's in it for me?
That's good.
That's what we get sometimes. We think only about us, and, you know, even when we pray sometimes, it's all about us and our families and our needs and what we want and how we want things to look. But rarely do we ever actually seek God with our now faith.
Yes.
You know, God, I'm using my now faith to the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And I tell people all the time, if you can see it, if it's tangible, if it's something that you can do for yourself, then what do you need God for?
That's what I always say too, because listen, you know, when you're younger, you hear older people talk about how, you know, you're going to, one day when you get older, you're going to see this. Well, I'm not trying to say I'm old or anything like that.
I know you're not.
But I have learned some things.
Absolutely.
And I really have. And I'm grateful for it. Absolutely. Because what I've learned is, I know today that truly, truly, that just these two words tells me that I can walk through anything. I don't even have to go further than that, because I know that without faith, I can't please God.
It's impossible.
So if I don't have a now faith, then it don't matter what's going on in my life. It's not going to work.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So them two words.
Let's keep reading. See what it says. Yes. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good testimony.
Mm-hmm.
By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible.
Okay. When I first read that, I thought, let me read that again.
Mm-hmm.
I had to look at it. I'm like, okay, so the things that were made by things that were not visible.
Call those things that are not as though they are. Yes. Mm-hmm.
So, and that's how God started this whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
So if he started it like that, then why can't we envision that God is going to do what he said he's going to do?
Absolutely.
Without me having to see it.
Why? Not only that, but he spoke it into existence.
Yes.
And that goes back to when he says that we have the power of life and death in our own tongues.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And speaking those things that are not as though they are.
Yes. Because he said that we would have the same powers if you believe.
Absolutely.
That I could speak it into existence too. But you know, we don't have that kind of faith.
That's the thing. Do we? I don't know. Do you? I don't know. I think that what we're doing here with Working with the Rue is wisdom for everyday life. Is that kind of thing.
Because
when we started this, we were like, I don't know where it's going to be. I don't know where it's going.
Clue.
I don't know. If we don't do anything else, we'll put it on Facebook and YouTube.
That's what we said.
That's what we're going to do. Somebody is going to come and say, you know what? That looks like it's pretty good. That's some not faith.
That's some not faith.
That's some speaking some stuff into existence that isn't. Yeah. Yeah. Way back in 2008, I was saying that people thought I was crazy. I'm going to get it. I don't know what TV station it's going to be on. I don't know how it's going to come about. I don't know how it's going to happen. And we started and stopped and started and stopped. But
yeah. You know what? And God told me years ago, when I was in college, and I'll try to hurry up and tell this story. When I was in college, they asked us to research our names.
Mm-hmm.
And so I researched my name, and my name Esther means star.
Mm-hmm.
Renee, which is my middle name,
mm-hmm.
means reborn.
Wow.
And so and my major was theater and dance. So I always wanted to be this star. Of course, I wasn't thinking godly, but you know.
Right, exactly.
I am now. But I always wanted to be the star. But this is the part. I hated my name.
Mm-hmm.
I really didn't, because I didn't know. I didn't understand who Esther was. It just sounded country.
Yeah.
The way people said it in Beaumont, it wasn't like Esther.
Uh-huh.
It was Esther.
Esther.
You know,
yeah,
that. So I didn't like my name. But when I realized what it meant,
right,
God spoke to me and told me. Now, it might not be the kind of star like, you know, the people be on TV. Mm-hmm. But in my eyes, in God's eyes, mm-hmm, I'm a star.
Exactly.
Reborn.
Exactly.
Doing what God told me to do.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Right.
Now faith.
Now faith. Ooh, let's keep reading.
Mm.
By faith.
Mm-hmm.
Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous. God testified of his gifts, and through it, he being dead, still speaks. By faith, Enoch was taken away. Wow. Mm-hmm. What kind of relationship is that with God?
Taken away.
I didn't even recognize it. I'm just gone. I'm talking to God. We just had a relationship. We just conversing, and I'm gone. I'm just,
I wonder if he was talking to somebody when God did that.
I wonder.
Wow. Can you imagine?
Wow. So he did not see that.
No.
He didn't see that.
But he saw God.
And that's...
That's what I'm talking about.
Isn't that all that's necessary?
Oh.
Okay, we're going to keep reading. We're not going to get it happening.
Okay, yeah, because we... Yeah.
Yeah. And was not found because God had taken him.
Mm.
For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased
God. Cheryl, you know what? I told somebody, I said, my ultimate desire, I promise you, my ultimate desire is that God be pleased with me.
Mm-hmm.
I really want, on that day, I want to hear God say, like the old people used to say,
mm-hmm,
well done, my good and faithful servant.
Absolutely.
I ain't trying to be good with people. I'm not trying to be this holier than thou, what they say, thing.
Mm-hmm.
I just want God to be pleased.
Mm-hmm.
And I know, really, I don't even know why this is not in Genesis.
Yeah, right.
Honestly.
Right.
Because without this verse, this chapter, which, you know, it talks about faith throughout the Bible, but chapter 11 in Hebrews just lays it out there for you.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that without this faith thing, God's not going to be pleased.
No, he's not.
Because that means God is no longer doing my life.
Mm-hmm.
I am.
And so many times, if we're not, it's so easy.
Mm-hmm.
Even in ministry, it's so easy. People call and say, come and do this. Okay, yeah, I'm going to go do that. And but a lot of, you recognize even in ministry, a lot of times, that everything is not a godly thing.
That's right.
Everything that they want to plaster Jesus' name on is not necessarily about Jesus.
Yes.
And if you're not careful and you don't use discernment and you don't go about it according to faith, and allow him to lead you and ask him, Lord, is this really what... You can get caught up real quick.
Yeah,
and I think we see a lot of our leaders sometimes getting caught up in that.
I made a decision, and I think you taught me this, that I didn't need to be at everything.
You don't have to be at everything.
And I had to become okay with that, because people try to make you feel bad when you don't show up.
Right.
But what I realized is God will send me where I need to go.
Where you need to go.
You know, and by faith I'll know
that
it's God and not man.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
And that's the stuff I want to do.
Yeah.
You know, I think I saw somebody the other day say something about good success and bad success.
Mm-hmm.
And again, even in ministry, there you see a lot of people elevating themselves and a lot of people getting to these pinnacles in ministry. And then all of a sudden they falter and they fall.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they go to the deepest depths. And it's because the success that they received was not necessarily good success. It was bad success because it was success that they aspired to.
Exactly.
It wasn't necessarily something that that God led them into, or something that God had ordained.
Mm-hmm.
It looked godly.
Mm-hmm.
It had an appearance of godliness, but with no power behind it, with no ordination.
What does the word say? In the last days, we're going to what? Have false teachers,
absolutely,
false prophets, all of that stuff. And it's happening.
And it's happening.
So we have to be careful to know this word and be careful. Ask God for discernment and have faith that he's going to give it to you.
And to be like Enoch. To the point that you have a relationship with him where you can just be talking to him and just be caught up in the spirit. And before you know it, you're like, oh, wait a minute, I done left.
Okay.
I was supposed to be on the way out. Where am I now?
Oh, I know. I'll be
and just be caught up and gone on with
he's
him.
Gone. That's what I'm talking
about. Wow. Let's see, what does it say? But without faith, it is impossible to please him.
Yes.
For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who what?
Earnestly seek him. Earnestly. What does that word mean? I wish I had my dictionary. Because I love looking up words. But people need to look up words and stop assuming that you know.
Mm-hmm.
Because somebody may think earnestly is just simple, honestly seeking God. If it was honestly, he would have put the word honestly.
Mm-hmm. Well, see, in my translation, it says diligently.
Diligently.
In other words, you're not giving up. Everything that you do, every breath that you take, every move you make, every step that you take is about seeking him. Everything, whether it be putting on clothes that day, whether it be who you're going to marry, whether it be where you're going to go for vacation, whatever, your jobs, all of that.
Mm-hmm.
When you're diligently seeking him, you ask him, Lord, what must I do?